Hi, everybody. What an incredible time to be able to lead a church or a business or whatever it might be through this era. For me, one of the highlights of my week is our Sunday gatherings. I love to see everyone. I love hundreds of people gathering to sing, worship, pray, and minister to the Lord as He ministers to us. I love talking to our people and laughing with them and praying with them and for them. I love the atmosphere that we have. It reminds me of what King David said. He said, "As for the saints who are in the earth, they are the majestic ones in whom is all my delight." I find great delight in those God has allowed me to shepherd. These challenging times have demanded we do things a little different than we normally have done it. Last Sunday, we adapted to the recommendation of keeping gatherings to less than 250. We had a plan for this week to adapt to gatherings of 50 or less. Then came the recommendation and request to limit our gatherings to 10 or less. So we created a plan for groups of 10 for this Sunday. Then Governor Wolf mandated the closing of all non-life-sustaining businesses, which we believe requires us to move away from the gathering in groups of 10 in this facility. So we are not going to be gathering in groups of 10 this week as we previously had planned. Now, let me tell you what we are going to do. First of all, at 9 a.m., we will have a live stream service with communion. So those of you who are part of our church, please prepare to have communion items at your house so you can participate with us. Then we're going to do something a little different. At 11 a.m., we're going to have a drive-in service in our upper lot here at the church. We're going to sing. We're going to worship together in our cars. We're going to pray. We're going to minister the word. And we're just going to see what God does. Can I tell you something? I'm getting a little excited to see what happens this week. Now, my preference is to have our normal gathering of hundreds of people, but you know, we're still gathering. We're just gathering differently. People are gathering in their homes because we know the church isn't a building. We're gathering through technology. And now, we're going to have some fun as we gather in our cars in our parking lot. You know, one of the things that we have to learn, and which we probably already know, but sometimes we have to operate by, is that God is beyond our systems. He's not limited to a system of Sunday services. He's not limited by the numbers in our gatherings or our buildings or our system of worship. Of course, we know this, but sometimes we don't operate by it. We like our systems. They're a place of comfort for us. And the truth is, we all have them. This time is challenging the systems of how we've done things. And it's not a matter of whether our systems have been right or wrong. It's just a matter of adapting them to the current situations with faith that God is beyond the system. And because our faith is in God and not the system, we make adjustments fully expecting Him to be faithful. Many of you have a system on how you attend church as well. You've become accustomed to a certain system of service or service times and style and a variety of other things. And the changing of the system is causing some to say, "I don't want to do this," or "I don't want to do that," or "I can't do it." Let me encourage you as well to get outside of your system. The same excitement I have for our usual Sunday gatherings is building in me for this coming Sunday and the different format that we're employing. The truth is, we are doing much of the same as we do every week. We're going to sing. We're going to worship. We're going to preach the word. And we're going to pray. We're just doing it differently, with full expectation that God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. I'm so glad He's beyond our systems. So I want you to be encouraged today that no matter what sphere of life you are in, God is bigger than your system. Allow faith in the one who's the same yesterday, today, and forever to adapt the system.